Hello and welcome to ANC Conversations. During the height of the lockdown period, there was a popular saying going around social media that reminded people of the importance of the arts. And it's true. When everyone was locked down in their homes, people turned to the arts, whether it be more mainstream forms like television shows or movies, to more interesting choices like musicals and virtual museum tours. In this episode, we check in on our local art scene to find out how the industry has been coping and to see how we can help support them. I'm Marie Lozano. Join me for a bit of conversation. The Ayala Museum has always aimed to bring Filipino culture, art, and history closer to Filipinos. Since the renovation started last year, they've been coming up with a variety of online content to keep this mission alive. Here with us today is Giselle Ong, Ayala Museum's Associate Manager for Marketing, to tell us more about this and what they have up their sleeves. Hi, Giselle.
Hi, Maria. Thank you for having me.
How is the museum coping with the pandemic?
We're doing pretty okay, as best as we can be in this situation. As you mentioned, we've been closed for renovation since last year. The staff all work from home, and then we really had to strengthen our presence online. Even if we were already on it, we had to do more on it to make sure that the people could still get that museum experience in the online space.
Yes, you mentioned that you you have an online presence. What else have you done to push this forward?
All right. So first off, last year we did launch our official YouTube channel, wherein we had original content, so written by the staff and produced for us. So it really tells about the story of the Filipino through our collection. So that's paintings and objects that really show our identity and what makes us uniquely Filipino. And aside from that, when the lockdown actually happened, we started to bring our permanent exhibition, so our Fernando Zobel Gallery and our diorama experience. We've worked to make it virtual, so we've created video series for these galleries so that people can still experience it, especially our dioramas, which have been iconic since the 70s, and it's been a useful tool for education, for teachers, and for kids.
Okay, so what was the reason why you went digital? Was it because of the renovation? You wanted to still be available, or was it because you really saw that there was a need to go digital for the museum?
I think both are true. So we've been very active on social media even way before. So we have our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and we engage with a lot of our followers there. But when we closed for renovations, there really was a need to be present while our physical space was closed. So that strengthened the idea of creating exclusively online content more, so that people can still experience us. But at the same time, it's not just being present, it's also giving access to more people, because not a lot of people, there's a wider audience out there aside from the people in Makati. And even with Filipinos, parang Filipinos from Visayas and Mindanao, they won't be able to visit our museum, maybe. Mm-hmm. So in a sense, us being online is our way to still give that access to them, to our collection, to art, to our history, and to our culture.
Okay, so what is Ayala Museum on the Go? What type of content is available there?
So Ayala Museum on the Go, actually, when we launched it last year, it had two aspects. One was our traveling exhibitions and our online experiences. For traveling exhibitions, we used to go to different schools. You know, we would bring our exhibitions and bring it to the public schools and to colleges outside of Metro Manila. But then the online experience would be our YouTube channel. But of course, since lockdown happened, we have been really single-mindedly focused on our online experiences. And aside from having our videos, we are also available in Google Arts and Culture. We have exhibitions there like The Art of the Malong, and the Filipinas Heritage Library also has exhibitions on women and war, as well as Manila Reborn. And aside from that, actually, we also have a lot of DIY activities for kids and for kids at heart. So we have resources that they can download, they can make their own flowers based on our exhibitions. So we have Filipinas Heritage Library, which, if you've been to the museum, is in our sixth floor. And they also have a Kimig collection, which is music collection. And they've curated playlists on Spotify as well that promotes OPM, so Filipino music from 70s to 80s, and they can access that. Like, people can access that there as well.
Yeah.
And we also put our concerts online. So we've had our rush hour concerts with the Manila Symphony Orchestra. So we repurposed it and made it available for online viewing at the same time, so people can still have access to these sort of live events in the online space.
Wow, that's a lot. Tell us, did you make or did you create new content for the ECQ and GCQ?
Yes, we definitely did. This week, actually, since it was Independence Day week, we had a whole slate of new online content, starting with our diorama. We made a three-part diorama series that featured our dioramas that talked about our aspirations for independence. So from Jose Rizal writing Noli Matanghere to our declaration of independence in Cavite. So they can also find that in our YouTube channel, ILMC YouTube. And what's really interesting was that yesterday we uploaded our VR360 film entitled Emergence of a Nation. So this would be part of our diorama experience in the museum. So it's making the dioramas come alive. And specifically for Emergence of a Nation, it talks about Bonifacio and Aguinaldo and the events that led to our independence as well. So this is a legit film. So it was produced with actors and all of that. And it makes you witness history in a different way, in a more unconventional way, since it has its 360 capabilities. This was actually part of our on-the-go traveling exhibitions before lockdown. So we would bring it to kids, to students, and it would really make them appreciate history more because you merge technology and history. So they find it more interesting and engaging. So now, since it was Independence Day, we wanted to have to spread that access to everyone as well. So they can access that until June 19 in our YouTube channel. In terms of what they can look forward to, well, we're constantly exploring this online space because there's a lot that we can do and there's a lot that we haven't explored yet. And we're looking forward to being able to recreate the programs that people have come to expect from us, but just putting them in an online space. So we're definitely exploring that and we'll definitely be creating more content like this.
Okay, you can never really compare a physical visit to a museum. But what are the pros of it?
I think one of the most interesting insights we've gotten from this experience is really the different types of audience we're now engaging with. especially using platforms that conventionally we wouldn't use. Like, for example, for International Museum Day last May 18, we made an Animal Crossing exhibition. Usually during International Museum Day, the museum would be free and we would be packed to the brim with people. And since we're not able to do that this year, we were thinking of how do we bring sort of recreate the gallery experience, but in available platforms. So we featured Juan Luna, Jose Honorato Lozano, and Damian Domingo. And people could visit our island and they could see, of course, Animal Crossing versions of the paintings. Mm-hmm. And I guess what I want to say is the online space allows us to interact with our audience in a different way. And it allows them to interact with art in a different way, in a way that they can understand more and that really piques their interest. And in that sense, once we have their interest, they get to learn more about our culture. They get to learn more about these artists.
What else can we expect from Ayala Museum?
You can look forward to perhaps seeing workshops and lectures available in our online pages as well.
I just wanted to ask, what is your favorite from all the exhibits in the digital platform of your museum?
Actually, my new favorite now is the diorama series that we released just this week, because I think the dioramas, they've been there since the 70s. And you go there for your field trips and all of that. But when you get to see them up close, Marianne, you can see the little details, which we do in the video part, it gives you a new appreciation for it. And it's always good to go back to our history, even if it's your grade school, high school history. It's a good reminder to have moving forward still.
For someone who wants to go on a museum day trip or a virtual trip, what would be your recommendations for, let's say it's their first time in your website?
So for people who do still want to have that museum date or that museum tour, I would definitely suggest they go to our website first. So, and of course, start with the exhibitions, because that is still the heart and the soul of the museum. So you can start, if you want to go through history, I would suggest going through the diorama videos. But if you want something that's more modern art, we also have that with our Fernando Zobel Toward Abstraction virtual visit. So with that, you're able to go through our permanent gallery in the physical space. You get a tour of it with narration from our senior curator. So it's like you're still getting that guided tour in the museum, assisted with the visuals of the gallery itself and the artwork itself by Fernando Zobel. If you want to learn more about being Filipino, you know, our identity, yes, I would suggest our original series on YouTube, which is called Atin and In Focus. So Atin really tells a thematic story through our paintings and through our objects. Like, we go through the idea of who is the Filipino anyway, what is the art of war. We go through the different our craftsmanship, because our ancestors are very talented, and they have crafted very intricate pieces of gold. And we want people to understand that and realize how talented we are as a people. We have a series called In Focus that takes you through an object tour, that takes you through the details of a certain object, like burial jars or gold peg teeth, or even female upper garment.
Okay, you just got me excited to visit the museum. I can't wait for my virtual tour. Thank you so much for joining us, Jess.
Thank you for having me, Maria.